then moved on to the research trends. So the topics which we discussed over there, barring a few, one or two career aggregation and career bonding, most of the topics, future prospects are an application in terms of 5G communication. These are all trending towards 5G communication. Then we discussed something about the device-to-device communication, a brief idea. Before I move on to a very small research problem of mine, this work is published in a telecommunications journal. So before I move into that, a research problem, so that you understand or get a brief idea how we have targeted that work. Before I move into that, I'll again discuss some of the integrated features of D2D with millimeter wave, D2D with IoT, and D2D with massive MIMO. So I'm going to cover these three small integrated features a bit more elaborately, and then we are going to go to one research. Okay, thank you. So let me just start. So just a second. So if I talk about basically, we all know that electromagnetic waves have a frequency ranging from 3 hertz to 3 into 10 to the power 20 hertz. So we have to understand that within this frequency, everything is there, whether it is a microwave, whether it is millimeter wave, whether it is X-ray, whether it is visible light communication, whether it is gamma rays, everything falls under electromagnetic waves. Now, microwave, if you see over here, microwave has a frequency range from 300 megahertz to 3 gigahertz, whereas millimeter wave has a frequency of 28 gigahertz to 300 gigahertz. Now, you might pose me a question, or you can think of a question, that when device-to-device communication is already possible in cellular band, as far as licensed spectrum is concerned, or if I take about a non-licensed spectrum, we usually use an ISM band for outband communication, which is 2.4 gigahertz. So why go to, or why move to 5G, why move to millimeter wave band? Because till now, there is no, there is, or 5, or if I go to millimeter wave, till now, practically there has been no cellular communication in millimeter wave band till now, as of yet. Although research has already started, people are trying to see or make use of this band. This is a very high frequency band, and to practically realize this band in your laboratory is very difficult, until and unless you have this very powerful 5G setup or those network analyzers which can work up to 30 to 40 gigahertz. It is very difficult to realize a millimeter wave signal very easily, because the wavelength is very, very low and the frequency is very high. Now, if I talk about a millimeter wave communication, this is a prospective technology for 5G cellular network in terms of producing very high data rate, probably to the order of gigabits per second. Now, if you look at the data rate which is required in 5G cellular communication, it is about 100 gigabits. Now, this data rate or this throughput of 100 gigabits can be satisfied with using millimeter wave technology. Now, if I take only D2D in sense, it is not possible to get a data rate as high as 100 gigabits. Using simple D2D communication, you can get maximum throughput of 1 gigabits. But if you have to apply D2D in millimeter wave, or you have to apply D2D in probably in 5G communication, there is a very beautiful way of adding D2D in 5G communication with the use of millimeter wave band. Now, if I talk about a millimeter wave band system, as you see, it has a very large bandwidth from 30 to 300 gigahertz. Now, we all know that when the frequency or when the bandwidth of any signal is high, it is bound to support high data rate communication. Okay. Now, our objective over here is to enable or to utilize D2D communication over directional millimeter wave band. And the reason to use, and the reason for doing so, is that our major objective over here is to utilize the large bandwidth of millimeter wave in such a way such that we can increase the network capacity. Now, network capacity can only be increased if your bandwidth is large, or if you divide your cell, for example, in cellular communication, if you remember, there were a few steps or there were a few ways by which the cellular capacity could have been increased. Say, suppose you have a cell, and in a cell you have a base station, you have a cellular users. Obviously, for a single cell, you know that a frequency is allotted to it. Now, you know that at a time you have to suffice to so many users. So what is done? You basically use a directional antenna, divide the cell into small number of cells, and for every small cell we use a directional antenna. As a result, we are trying to reuse the frequency. Once the frequency is being reused, we say the capacity is also increasing, because more the number of users you are targeting, more will be your capacity. Same over here also. As the bandwidth is more, our major objective is to support a very high data rate, and to support this very high data rate, our capacity requirement is also very high. Now in millimeter wave band, if you see, it supports very high frequency band from 30 to 300 gigahertz. It supports a data rate of 10 gigabits per second. Now, when the frequency of this band is very high, obviously the data rate it supports is up to 10 gigabits per second. Okay. Now, the limitation of this of using millimeter wave band, I would say, is the range. The range is limited to about a kilometer, not more than a kilometer. And one more thing, how is it possible to enable D2D communication in millimeter wave is by the use of this narrow beam width, which we are talking about a while ago about beam forming. So beam forming is basically a signal processing technique whereby what we can do is that we can make the radiation pattern to be directive, so that the signal coverage is only localized within a certain area, it doesn't exceed that area. So once your radiation pattern or the signal which you transmit is only limited to a certain area, you expect to have a very high throughput communication within that coverage area, and that is only possible because of millimeter wave. So that was a shining star kind of a thing, which actually allowed the researchers to exploit millimeter wave communication in device to device. Now, if I talk about device to device communication, we know that basically gives connection now, between two wireless devices without using a base station or an e-node B. Sometimes we refer to the base station in D2D as an e-node B also. E-node
so
B.
By clicking here,
so there are two ways how a D2D devices communicate. One is a local D2D communication, the other is a global D2D communication. So if I talk about a local D2D communication, as you see over here, in local D2D communication, the wireless devices establish the connective communication path under the same base station. So here you see there are two pairs of D2D devices. And please understand that even though the data transfer between these two devices is taking place directly, but at the end of the day, there is a certain governance of a cellular base station which is controlling. Just controlling the control part for both these devices.
And so this,
even though data transfer is between these two devices, the communication path which is associated between these two devices is actually governed by the
at least for base station.
Local D2D communication, the communication between the wireless source, devices or the devices which are communicating
from the
have to be under the same base station.
Now, okay. We don't have this hardware.
In a case when this is not possible, now, that the two devices which are under a local base station cannot communicate, the only reason could be some blockage.
So when you connect this,
there is a line of sight blockage.
If you run
when
this,
is the scenario, then one of the D2D devices can basically act as a relay in transmitting the signal from the source to the destination. Now, in normal wireless
GRC
communication, we see that
GRC
when a data is not getting propagated from the source to the destination, what we do, we apply a relay node.
I'm saving.
So the relay node is basically propagating the signal from the source
now
to the destination via the relay
running
node. And in the relay node, we use those regenerative repeaters or amplifiers to regain the signal strength and then to forward it to the destination. The same thing happens over here also. In case there is a line of sight blocking, what do you understand by line of sight? Line of sight is basically when the receiver and the transmitter are not in the same line, are not in the same path. So basically, in a sense that the receiver is not able to see whether transmitting signal is being transmitted.
And then once again.
Now, if I talk about global D2D communication, basically it connects two wireless devices. And if you see both these wireless devices are under the governance of some
now
different
base stations. Now you are seeing this is the output screen.
Then this is the scenario, which is a combination of device to base as well as base to base.
This is called spectral plot.
So the sender device
communicates
with the sender base station. The sender base station communicates with the receiver base station. And then the receiver base station communicates with the
receiver. Actually, if you want to see
this spectrum,
we suppose to have a spectrum analyzer.
Once this control part is done, then the devices can directly communicate,
we need
then
not
the device
to have
of say probably belonging to base station 1.
The next plot is called waterfall display.
Device of a base station.
Waterfall display.
So this is how
there.
Your local D2D communication and your global D2D communication
is
all
in
and
the taxes.
One more thing, if you look at the,
that is
look at the diagram
actually
on the left side.
It is running.
This is more of an omnidirectional.
The
first one is more of an omnidirectional pattern. So you see the coverage
is
just
slow.
Not limited to
that's why there are
single
some
device,
are
but
coming.
It is
actually
spread over
the
those two base
signal.
Stations and three or four
because
devices.
Of the lagness
but if you look at the second
computer,
diagram, you find
it like
that.
That
it is basically
when you go for a time
say,
domain,
directed only
this is
at a certain device or particular to a certain region.
You are seeing the two different
waveforms. So that there is a very high throughput or a very high capacity which can be obtained
this
in that
signal is called
or your signal strength
signal.
At that place.
When you see
very,
the complex
very
signal in the
high.
Constellation plot, IQ plot, everyone
now,
is aware of what is the meaning of IQ
plot.
As we
were seeing that
real
even
axis,
though D2D communication can be
if you plot
exploited
that, like
in millimeter
but
wave
for
communication
signal,
because
actually,
of the advantages which millimeter wave offers. There are a few limitations
now,
which the millimeter wave suffers.
Frequency display.
The first and the foremost being path loss. So if I have to
now,
I have
my
to talk
query
about
is that
the path loss.
When you
now, basically when any electromagnetic signal is transmitted over a system or over a
we
channel,
the
major problem
as a
suffers
signal.
From is path loss because
but
of
I suppose to
multipath
have only
propagation.
One signal.
Now the path
what to do?
The
what
name
is the meaning
path
of a real signal
is given by because you try any signal
that?
which gets received at the receiver due to the multipath propagation suffers
what is
from
the difference
various
between
obstacles.
Real signal and
so the obstacles could be such as due
this
to reflection, due to refraction,
scenario.
Due to
in
scattering,
industry or whenever
et cetera,
you create any problem
these
or
the
application development.
The signal might face,
we must be clear
and as a
what
result
type of
which
signal we are going to
the
give.
Path
whether
loss
it is a complex signal
is a
or
major concern in millimeter wave
signal.
Communication. So as to eradicate this problem of path loss, what has been done is that
naturally,
this directional antenna has been
signal,
used.
All signals will be real signal.
If you are using this directional antenna, your coverage
the
or your radiation
is
pattern
good,
is only
is
focused at a certain area. So if this is the concern, then the path loss in this scenario
cause,
will be much, much lesser. As compared to if a omnidirectional antenna would have been used.
I want to utilize
therefore,
that signal.
To reduce the path loss, there will be path loss. There is no doubt at all that path
for
loss will not be there. Path loss will always
okay.
be there
I'll
in millimeter wave communication.
Later,
but as a communication engineer,
so
our objective would be to minimize that path loss
instead
to the
of this
so,
one.
To minimize
if
this
I
path
want
loss,
to change this
high directional
into real signal.
Antennas,
okay.
high gain directional antennas
so there
have
is
been
an option.
Used to compensate for this loss.
Here in
then
the
second
tool.
Is that we see that in case of line of transmission is not possible in case
in
of millimeter wave communication. Now when I talk
types.
About line of sight as
the
I have already
color
said, the receiver and
the blue
transmitter
color,
must be in the same
color.
Path of propagation. Now
it is telling that
understand
okay,
that
this
is not possible in case of millimeter wave communication
wherever
because
you see,
millimeter wave communication has
color,
a lot of obstacles
bit,
starting from rain attenuation
representation
to
of the
XYZ obstacles. So this possible of
that
line of sight communication is not possible in millimeter wave communication. So
it's called a real signal.
Whatever you see over here is basically
through our
a
microphone whenever we speak all
now,
these
there is a non line of sight
coming under the
it is understood
signal.
That there will be significant attenuation. So to reduce the attenuation what has been done
access,
is that we divide the cell into smaller
here.
Number of cells
so before that I will change the data type here
pico cells
so I want to cut
macro cells depending upon what is the requirement. If we require a
float.
Very small cell
click.
For example a femto cell which is of the order of 10 meters
okay.
to give you a good coverage in those
but
10 meters area
here it
then
is a float
I think femto cell is the best.
But here
you
it is a complex that's why it is showing
connectivity
the
over say probably 100
so once
meters
again, double click here
we design the cell in such a way that such that it
on the remaining settings, you need not worry as of now.
To eradicate path loss, we use high directional
beam antenna. Now, when you run this,
and to reduce the diffraction around the obstacles,
which we have studied in the
smaller
digital communication
code, issues which
are analog communication code
are faced by millimeter wave, and to reduce that, we use these.
When we generate a
and the third most important problem is limited penetration capability.
X of t is equal to
that
a sine
is why the coverage
omega
of millimeter wave signal is very, very limited.
If that a sine omega t is a signal,
cannot penetrate a building, because you see at 40, even at high frequency of 40 gigahertz, there is an attenuation of 180 dB over a brick wall around 20 dB over a painted wood. So it's very difficult for a millimeter wave signal to penetrate any building. That is why
this particular is
we cannot
spectral plot says that
for, we can
the
use
signal which we have generated
very small
come from
short
the
range communication
here,
but that's
generating
not
a signal
large area.
At a
for example
with the
in our homes we can easily use Wi-Fi signals. Okay,
this is the property of my signal.
We can use Wi-Fi signals.
Floating
they
point,
also work in unlicensed
sampling
band
rate,
around 2.4
gigahertz.
So we can use that. The coverage is also good because it can cover 2-3
frequency is 1000 Hz.
Your building walls,
amplitude is 1 volt.
That is not the case.
This is called a DC offset.
It is very restricted. The
so,
range is
1000
very less.
Hertz sinusoidal.
It is only restricted to probably a few.
So that 1000 Hz sinusoidal signal, a sine omega t.
Despite the fact that
when you take
four times
of a sine omega t,
D2D communication or
a sine omega t actually can be represented in terms of e power j beta
and tries to reduce the limitations in millimeter
e
wave
plus j omega
so
t
as to obtain a very high
plus
throughput
e power minus
and
j omega t
to achieve the condition of good energy
so
efficiency
in the complex
and good
basis only actually the,
now, the current 4G cellular networks which
so
we are using currently which we
e
are at the time we all are using provide a seamless coverage, non-stop coverage is there.
That's
reliable
the reason we are getting a frequency component
lower frequency
e power plus j theta
the 4G band which is used for cellular communication,
any real
device
signal,
device
whenever we write
much lesser
sine omega
than
t
the millimeter wave band which is used,
we will be getting a signal like this.
Cost efficient transition. Now if
in
we have to move from 4G
domain
to 5G,
but when it comes
we have
to time
use a hybrid system.
It's a single
the diagram
signal
which is at your right,
but earlier
is an example
we had a
millimeter wave technology.
What's
can
the meaning of the earlier and this
4G
one?
4G system or into or 4G system.
This is
mathematically
how can I
write
is that?
D2D uses.
A
now we see that the
omega
interference
d
among the millimeter concurrent
for some
links
other frequency,
that the present links can be negligible.
But earlier complex
but the directional pattern, the blue directional patterns which are there, they are pseudo wired. Pseudo wired matlab
e power j omega
it looks as if there is a wired communication,
is
it
maybe
an
a,
but it is a proxy wired communication.
E power j omega t is equal to
now,
exponential.
We have to understand. Say suppose if I see a cell, there
that
are three cells over here. Now if I see a cell, as
very,
you can see, there is a connectivity
and,
between
important
millimeter wave base stations.
Now,
okay, by using directional link, there is also a link between D2D's devices, and there is also a link between base station and the D2D device.
The signal is generated,
is
and we are seeing
directional.
Okay, now I'm going to
your
show
signal,
you
flow pattern is all about. So the problem with traditional
audio
D2D communication is that it obviously uses omnidirectional antenna. Why? Because the coverage requirement
audio
is much higher if it was only catering to
I think
D2D communication.
Integrated.
But our motive over here is to achieve a very high throughput. Now, if we have to have a very high throughput, so we have to take advantage of the propagation loss of millimeter wave.
Directly to this
so, thing. In order to cater to the problem of propagation loss in millimeter
see
wave, we use directional antenna. Once we are using directional antenna, what is happening is that we can support in that same cell.
Now
we can
I'll
support more number of D2D links.
We'll see how it works.
Once we support more number of D2D links in a single cell scenario, what we are doing? We are increasing the capacity. So as we are increasing the capacity,
hello,
we are aren't we
speaking my voice the speech
efficiently
which
increasing
speaking,
the spectrum
no,
efficiency also. So in a way
what I'm speaking
with millimeter wave we are actually
that
increasing
time
the
domain
capacity
plot,
increasing
signals,
the throughput and trying to
silence
remove the and trying to utilize the disadvantages of millimeter wave
whenever I'm speaking
as a advantage
this is my speech signal which you are saying
combine
in
that with. Now there are huge number of problems which are there. The most
hello
important problems even
I'm welcoming you all for this session. This is my speech.
Remains the same.
Now I'm seeing
there's
this spectrum
of
that
interference which is an issue.
You see,
there's a problem of resource allocation.
From 0 to 5 kilohertz, up to
once
the
0 cellular
to
user
5 kilohertz,
is free,
all the maximum
to
which, frequency
to which
components
user
will lie.
You allot that frequency to?
After
that is
5
concern,
kilohertz,
so
all these components will be very low.
Security is a concern because security
that's the reason
is a problem
our human being
eavesdropper.
To record
as
our human
wave is a high frequency and most of the bands in millimeter wave are unlicensed. So there is a
we
chance
need,
8,000
samples per second.
Dropping.
By assuming that
there can be
a natural phenomenon,
intuition from some
the
other
signal has to be sampled
some other unlicensed
users
to in order to what to say in order 8, to
8,000 samples per second.
In order to
sorry, not less than
decode your signal,
more
so
than.
Which is actually a
but the minimal
is actually a
limit
primary
is
concern.
8,000 samples
so,
per second. The reason is
the
that
major
we can
goal or the major goal
this.
Would be to use
okay.
a secured system.
Now,
to apply good physical, to have a good physical layer security, and the physical layer security can be achieved
instead
by
of
using
this audio
optimization
source,
algorithms.
If I'm connecting my USB source
joint
algorithms,
over here, algorithms,
then automatically I can see
individual algorithms also, which can be applied.
Now,
so in a way, we have to actually use.
If you want to change,
what we are doing, discussing
I'm disabling
here,
this. I'm enabling
the
this
features
other
of millimeter wave into D2D so that. We take the advantage of higher throughput.
What are all the facilities are there?
Capacity,
I will delete this.
Good coverage.
Because,
as,
I'm going to show.
Not a good coverage, a limited coverage to that.
Yeah,
area,
the code which is generated
increases spectral efficiency.
Here I gave a top now, underscore
if
block.
If we talk about
instead,
the structure of network or the structure, how the data is being what to say is being transferred.
One.
It is all happening
demo
in PDMA slots. So,
you
so
see,
it happens. So in TDMA, what we do is that in
like
time
this.
Division multiple access,
demo
the multiple users
this.
Which are present access
generate,
the data using access the data in time slot. Now you understand
what
if
that,
in this TDMA, if we could have used a
this
lower kind of a structure,
generate the Python
if in this
code.
TDMA,
I am going to show
TDMA,
the Python code for all of you.
In millimeter 5G, a NOMA kind of a structure, it could have sufficed to more number of users also. So
by clicking this, this is my current
technology should
area,
be a boon for us. Now I take the second topic where
yes.
I am going to talk about millimeter wave in
initially
communication.
We had
sorry,
another name is called top
MIMO
underscore block. That's why it has generated top underscore block.
You understand MIMO is
file.
All about multiple
now,
input and multiple
I have
output
changed
items.
Into the demo
so
on
here
that
we
UI.
Discuss these two
now it is generating
what to say, two,
when I compile
diagrams, one about the point to point and multi
flow graph.
So if you see this point to point, we have
one.
Two antennas, one at
the
transmitter the, and one at the receiver.
That Python code.
We have a transmitter and a receiver. Each of these transmitters and the receivers have T number, that the transmitting has T number of antennas, the receiver has R number of antennas.
Open the
gedit. It is basically a point to point. So the users, what the users are basically point to point. So if you see the propagation is from one to the it is from the transmitter, the first transmitting antenna to the first receiving antenna,
so
or the TH here? Transmitting antenna to the first receiving antenna, or to the second transmitting antenna to the first receiving antenna. So it's a more of a point-to-point MIMO. Whereas if you see the second one, it is a multi.
Yes.
So there are
actually as a programmer, we supposed
users,
to write a code
and
like this.
And every user has its own
under
individual antenna. Whereas
all
a receiver
things,
is one fixed structure having
you know all the block
M
data,
antennas.
What are the functions,
so
name,
in this scenario, your users
if we
are
know
in,
all those,
each having some antennas. So
this is our
so
actual
there is
blocks.
A, so there is a direct
this
connection. So there is a connection
block,
between each of the
name,
antennas of the user with the receiving
with
antenna.
The parameters,
so it is more of a multi-user
all
kind
these
of
settings.
Okay, whereas
as a computer science engineer, if we are fully on that,
now
we can write all these codes.
Why do I say MIMO works best in rich multipath environment?
The
what
companion
do I
what actually
rich
is
channel?
Doing
rich channel has different
it is
paths
helping
of
us to generate this
not
Python
only
code.
That a rich channel apart from
when
different path of propagation the receive signal which you receive should have
when
unstructive
we this
interference
then execute
so once
button,
the receive signal
what actually it is happening
receive
is
receive at the destination if it has a
nothing
constructive
is
interference
in the
that is the amplitudes are added so that the gain is a positive one
what is that
so we will see
that Python code.
That we, in such a scenario,
Python
we see
file
that the channel works best. Okay, and the more important is that in millimeter wave.
Python is the interpreter language. The meaning of interpreter language is that each statement which we are seeing in the Python, actually we need not to run or compile every time. Need not to be compiled. Every statement will run automatically. That's called interpreter language. That interpreter language, whenever we are pressing that button, it will run, because it is very important to understand this. That's all. This is very fundamental of to explore about Genie Radio, and now we will move to the next level of development. Okay. So now, herein, in the test1.grc, in the GNU Radio file, in this environment, there is one module is called Filter Design Tool. By clicking this Filter Design Tool, okay, before that, I want to add one more information. I was talking about the sampling rate, no? Here, the sampling rate was given as a 32,000. So, as per the Nyquist rate, the half of the frequency we can give as an input. At least maximum of 16,000 hertz can be given as an input. If it exceeds more than 16,000, there will be an aliasing. Now I will demonstrate that aliasing effect now lively. Okay. To do that, we need some tool is called QT sync. Sorry, QT range. If you take this as a range, I can change the variable name as FREQ, frequency. So since it's the sampling rate is 32K, I suppose to give minimal frequency is equal to 0, maximum is 16,000. Every step can have 100. Okay, if I am giving to demonstrate around 20,000 values, apply. Okay, this ID can be used over here as frequency FREQ, you can type. Then amplitude also will change like that, AMP. So we need one more QT range. QT range, which has to provide the change in amplitude during the runtime. Amplitude may be minimum 0.1. Stop at 5 volt. Step may be 0.1. So it may ask about one default value is equal to 1. Stop value may be 0.1. Okay. Apply this. Yeah. So now it is ready. During runtime, how to change it? Now I will run this program. Run it. So by clicking this FREQ, if I am changing the frequency over here, 150, you see here the signal which I have generated, actually it is the now anyone can say the signal which I have generated, it's a real signal or complex signal. So I need some reply from the participants. Yes, please. From the spectrum, how can we say what type of signal is this? Okay, from the time domain, is it real or complex?
Naresh? Praveen?
So I'm not hearing any sound.
No,
yes, is it real or complex?
Power problem.
Praveen?
Sir, try to work out the chat box.
Sir.
Yeah, yeah, okay. I will look into that.
Please, yes, please. Go in the resource person.
Chat box.
Maybe a power problem.
Okay.
Chat, okay.
Conduct, right.
Real signal, time domain. Okay. Now, here when we change the frequency of this, we can see that it is also shifting. It's a single tone. Now, I want to add multiple frequencies. If you want to add multiple frequencies, copy this. I'll stop this. Copy, paste. Second frequency, frequency plus 500 hertz. Whatever it may be the frequency I am generating, in
Hello?
Addition to that, there will be a.
Hello, is it audible?
Minus.
Yeah, audible, sir.
I think some there was some network issue, na?
Minus 0.2.
So let me just continue. So is my slide visible?
I have to add two signals.
Hello, is it audible?
So there is an option.
Hello,
yeah, audible, sir.
Okay. I think some there was some network issue, na?
If you type add.
Now, if I was talking about the network architecture, just current. So is my slide visible?
The traditional
change into.
The traditional
complex.
If I talk about the traditional D2D communication in MIMO communication,
no, if I
so there are two basically two
architectures.
Current and
other
is a multi-user.
The traditional
is a point-to-point. The traditional is between two users having n number of antennas.
Talk about the traditional D2D communication
in
basically
MIMO communication pattern.
So there are
basically two ways. One is a
point-to-point
and the other is a multi-user
one.
So in case of point-to-point. It is between two users having n number of antennas
so
at both ends, and
I...
it's basically the radiation pattern or the channel gain is basically between each.
You see here. Actually, we supposed to see only the half of the component from zero to positive side. We gave a 32k, 32,000 sampling rate. That's why from 0 to 16 right side. From 0 to 16 minus the totally 32k. So what does it mean is that our sampling rate is nothing but our the window size, how much signal which I can see at a time, that depends on what is our sampling rate. At this moment we are seeing only this window of the spectral window of 16 plus plus 16 minus 16, totally 32 kilohertz of the bandwidth. This is called a bandwidth. If I increase the my sampling rate here from 64, 32 to 64, now you can see there. So why I'm explaining all this point is that these are all the key points which we have studied theoretically. When it comes in the reality, how it look like, that we can experience it. Okay. Now, if I am changing the frequency, you see, from 0 to...
Yeah, there is a network issue within the session with internet.
From 0 to 34 and 0 to minus 34. Now, we are seeing the total bandwidth of 64 kilohertz of the channel width. So comparing with the earlier, it is a little bit, we are seeing the very wider band spectrum. So it is very important how to choose our sampling rate. Here the sampling rate unnecessarily if I increase, the system will get load, lot of load on the signal processing. Okay, that we must be very much careful on this. Now, I have to demonstrate the aliasing effect for signals. 32,000 apply. When you run this, it will be good if I am choosing only one frequency than two. Disable, connect directly to this. Okay. Now I'm going to change the frequency to demonstrate the what is the effect of aliasing. when actually we are increasing the frequency more than, now it is 10 kilohertz, 9, 10, you see here. After 15, actually, if you have done installation, all this in your standalone system, all these things will be very fast. Since it is running in a virtual environment, it is taking a little bit slow. When I am increasing more than 15 kilohertz, it means that 16 plus. What is the meaning of aliasing? You see, one new component is actually coming back. This is called aliased component. When we start giving explanation about joined, what is the meaning of aliasing, you can give the explanation like this. So there is a, what is the meaning of this one that you can
use. And the mail,
so I'm not going in depth on that.
Pass, that will be considered for your as a attendance.
Yeah.
Please, if not, do you not did still now, you can please
post the email. Delete this.
If you have any queries also, you can post it in your box. Thank you.
Now, how to design a one filter? There is a module is called Filter Design Toolbox. By clicking the Filter Design Toolbox, you can see a separate application. It will take some little bit time. Please hold on. Yes, this is called a Genie, two times it's open, Genie Radio Filter Design Toolbox. See, as a design engineer, a digital signal processor engineer, if you want to design a DSP processor based application development, if you want to define the signal processing application, either it may be a filter, where FIR is coming, IAR is coming, whatever type of filter you want, we can design here, which is the same facility is already available in MATLAB also. Now I'm going to design a FIR filter, type of filter FIR, low pass, Hamming window, sampling rate which we gave there. What is the sampling rate which we gave? 32,000. Use the same sampling rate, filter gain. Okay, end of the passband.
That is here muted.
That means up to the 5 kilohertz, all signal has to be permitted. After the 5 kilohertz,
sir, you are muted. Excuse me, sir.
6 kilohertz, the signal should not be permitted. It means the stop band. Start of the stop band. From 5000 to 6000, it is actually transition band. If you reduce the transition band, that is also good.
Now, is it has been interrupted from
our specification is over.
Which is happening, na?
Twice this transition band is very important. Now I am designing. If I am clicking this design, this is my required design parameter.
Yes, sir, you can continue.
Frequency response or magnitude response of my system.
As we were talking about MIMO, MIMO
you
works
see here, there is a transition
a rich multipath environment because
zero,
in case,
hertz
as far as MIMO is concerned, right, we have multiple inputs and multiple outputs.
Is a frequency.
So if there are, if you have a scenario where there are multiple input antennas and multiple output antennas, obviously the receiver end you are going to receive multiple copies of the same transmitted signal. And this is only possible because the signal travels through multiple directions or multiple paths.
There
so
was
at
a
the
system,
end, so at the
gave
end,
the input
when
from
we
that
have a signal
a input,
which has multiple copies
has
of the same transmitted
like
signal,
this.
The signal is bound to be reliable, it is bound to be
the Fourier
rich,
transform
it
of the
give
simple
you a
response
good.
Is the
so multiple antennas basically leads
this
to the property of diversity which I was talking about.
So
all
if you have multiple antennas, both
are
the transmitter and the receiver, and the receiver receives multiple copies of the same transmitter signal,
I'm not
at the end of the day, we achieve good diversity. Once you achieve good diversity, provided your fading constraints are okay, your receiver will obviously give you a good bit of data
performance.
MIMO can also be used to increase data rate. Why? Because once your channel capacity increases, once your entire capacity increases, obviously your data rate is, or your throughput is proportional to your capacity. So this will also increase. And how is this possible? This is possible by connecting parallel streams of antennas, which is also known as spatial
multiplexing.
If I take this diversity basically as I was telling, the diversity in this case scenario in MIMO is actually a reliability scenario. Why? Because the major goal of high reliability is the primary goal of any wireless communication system. And the reason being is diversity. So as I was talking about diversity means you're getting the same replication of the transmitted copy of the signal. Now the diversity has basically three modes: phase, frequency and time. So in time diversity could be there, frequency diversity could be there, and space diversity could be there. As far as MIMO is concerned, the diversity is basically in space domain.
So there will be one single LNC component.
If I'm talking about a space domain diversity, it is identified by the array of transmitters.
One element of LNC combined is called.
If I talk about a frequency domain diversity, it is how it is represented by the fact that the bandwidth is divided into n smaller bandwidths, n smaller bands, and where each band can be utilized for transmitting a signal. As far as time domain is concerned, so you divide the total time into smaller time slots, where each time slot will be used for data transmission. Now this is an example of space diversity. If you look over here, the blue signal moves from the mobile to the antenna, whereas there is another blue signal which is a copy of that signal which reaches the antenna through an obstacle which is the house. So at the end you are receiving two multiple copies of the same signal. So if I talk about the red signal,
there is one signal
which is from one mobile node to this receiving antenna, and the one comes to the other obstacle.
What is the advantage of this? When you increase the order, what will happen?
Done in MIMO is that the receive signal is added.
Now,
so once you add the signal, you get a better enhanced version of your receive signal. So if you compare now the received and the transmitted signal, you will find that the performance, and if you analyze the performance, you will find that the received signal is more or less similar to what your transmitted signal was all about. And that is the only reason why using MIMO, using the concept of space diversity,
if I design my filter, now you see the number from 59 to.
This is an example of how your MIMO antenna looks like.
Order of the filter.
Suppose you have a transmitter which has
indirectly what's
m different inputs.
When I increase the order of the filter,
the channel is nothing but all the transmitting, how the transmitting antenna is connected to the receive antenna. Now if you look over the first red line, it is basically connecting the first transmitting antenna to the first receiving antenna. Then H21 is basically connecting the second receiver antenna to the first transmitting antenna.
And
whereas the last one is connecting the nth antenna to the first transmitting antenna. Similarly, so there is a one-to-point link between all the transmitting and the receiving antenna. So at the end, I can say that all the receiving antennas are having multiple
from
copies
the linear function,
or are having
if I know the mathematics
m number of
one,
copies of the
I can estimate
signal, whether it is
this much
the
amount
first
of
antenna
the
y1, whether it is y2, whether it is yn. So y1, y2, yn are all having
then
m multiple copies of the transmitted questions signal.
This is
now the objective of the receiver is to actually combine the signal
inside,
to get the best possible
select
output
all the
signal. So if you look at the receive signal, the receive signal is basically the sum of all the gains you get from the impulse responses, H11, H21. Now how to solve this? That can actually be represented in the form of a matrix, which is shown at the below. The channel H11, H12. So what is this H11, H12? These are the channel gains obtained from the receive. Say suppose H11. So this denotes probably, H11 denotes the the channel gain of the first and the first transmitting and the first receiving antenna. H12 might represent the channel gain of the first transmitting and the second receiving antenna.